Hey, hi guys, how are you all? Hope you people are doing well. So in today's class, I want to highlight on the Prime Minister of our country. How the Prime Minister will be appointed, who appoints the Prime Minister, what will be the qualification of the Prime Minister, and what will be the tenure, what are his functions. About all this thing, we'll going to learn in this particular class. So when I talk about Prime Minister, the name itself say he is the head of the government. The Prime Minister, he will be the head of the government. And in our previous class, we learned that President, he will be the head of the country. Don't get confused with the President and Prime Minister. President of the country, he will be the head of the country, and Prime Minister, he will be the head of the government. Whichever the government ruling in our country, that government's head post will be holding by this particular Prime Minister. So Prime Minister is the head of the government, and he look after towards the administration of the country, and he as a Prime Minister will be head of the Council of Ministers. And this particular Prime Minister, he will be acting as the real executive authority. So we know that the head of the executive powers in our country is President, but real executive authority will be the with Prime Ministers of our country. So whatever the Prime Minister suggests to the President, he will be agreeing on that. Again, the Prime Minister, he will be the chief or the head of the government, as I always said. Again, the Prime Minister of our country, he acts as the advisor to the President. He gives the advice to the President. So what has to be done for the development of this particular nation? Then the Prime Minister in our country, he will be, okay, whoever becomes the Prime Minister of this country, they becomes the ex officio chairmen of, there are many councils. So here I want to highlight on ex officio chairmen. So these are the posts ex officio chairmen. So where whoever becomes the Prime Minister, they directly becomes the chairmen of these posts. So whenever they will not select individually as a chairman of these particular bodies. So whoever the Prime Minister, that Prime Minister will be the chairman of these councils. Like the Prime Minister will be the head of the or chairman of the Niti Aayog. He will be the head of the National Development Council, which is NDC we say. And the Prime Minister, he will be the head of National Integration Council, that is NIC. And as a Prime Minister, he will be the ex officio chairman of Interstate Council, which is ISC. Like this, the Prime Minister of our country will be acting as the head of the government. After that, I want to highlight on the qualification to become this Prime Minister. Guys, if you check with your book, somewhere they have missed this part. So I thought I will inform you this extra information. So when we talk about qualification to become the Prime Minister, first qualification is he must be a citizen of India. So whoever want to become a Prime Minister of our country, he must be a citizen of India. That is the first qualification. And if I move to second qualification is he should be a member of Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha. So the one who wants to become a prime minister of this nation, either he should be a member of a Lok Sabha or else member of a Rajya Sabha. This Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha, we have already done it. Okay, so if you don't remember anything, go to my previous videos and check with that. Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, already we have done it. So either he has to be a Lok Sabha member or he has to be a Rajya Sabha member. So that is the second qualification. And a third qualification to become this prime minister is he or she should be above 25 years of age if they are from Lok Sabha. If they are from Rajya Sabha, then he or she should have age of 30 or more than that. So this is the third qualification which we require to become the prime minister of our country. Apart from this, a very common man can become a prime minister. So for that, the best example is a popular and dynamic prime minister of today's government, or a present prime minister of our nation, that is Narendra Modi. So he says he has sold the tea in the railway station, so Chaiwala has become the prime minister of our country. So like this is the power, this is the liberty given in the Indian constitution. So a common man can head the government and he can lead the whole nation. So that is about the qualification to become the prime minister of our country. Then I will move towards the appointment of the prime minister. How and who appoints this particular post called prime minister? So in the Indian constitution, article 75 of the constitution, it talks about prime minister's appointment, and the prime ministers of India shall be appointed by the president. So president of our nation appoints the prime ministers. So that is about the appointment of the prime minister. And next I will move towards the term of tenure. So once they become the prime minister, for how many years they will be holding that particular post. So when you talk about term of a tenure of a prime minister, one thing is, what you have to remember is, the term of the prime minister is not fixed. So that is the one thing. What happens, he holds the office during the pleasure of the president, and so long as the prime minister enjoys the majority support in the Lok Sabha, he cannot be dismissed by the president. So what this sentence tells is, so until and unless, till he is having the support of Lok Sabha members, he can be a prime minister. Once he loses the support of Lok Sabha members, then he has to resign from that particular post. So here, this particular term of a tenure, what we have to remember is, the term of a tenure of a prime minister of our country is not fixed. Term of a tenure of the government is fixed, but the position, that particular position of the prime minister, it is not fixed, guys. Okay, so the prime minister term of a tenure is not fixed. So as long as he enjoys the support of the Lok Sabha members, he will be on that particular post. Once he loses the support of the Lok Sabha members, then he has to resign, or else a president will dismiss that particular thing. Then that is about the term of a tenure of this particular prime minister. Then next, what we'll do, powers and powers and functions of prime minister we will discuss. So when we talk about powers and functions of prime minister, so the main power is he appoints, as a prime minister, he appoints the ministers, and he has the power to remove these particular ministers, and allocation of the portfolios that will be done by this particular prime minister. Next, prime minister will be the head of the government, then he will be the head of the union cabinet. So let's discuss these points one by one. So as I told you, the appointments of the ministers will be carried out by the prime ministers. The prime ministers recommends to the president the appointment of the ministers to the council of ministers. So he also allocates the various portfolios among the ministers, and the decision in the appointment of the minister, in the finalizing the allocations of the portfolio, is the final. So prime minister, he is the having a final decision on that, who has to become the home minister of a country, who has to lead minister of home affairs, who has to lead minister of defense, who has to lead the minister of road transport, who has to lead minister of micro and small medium enterprises, who has to lead the minister of chemicals. Like this, the decisions will be taken by the prime ministers. So prime minister, he suggests to the president, and president will be appointing these particular ministers, the cabinet ministers who will be working under the prime minister's post. So that is the one thing, appointment of the ministers. That is the major function and major power what the prime minister has, and removal of the minister. If any minister, if he is not working properly for his ministry, if he is not developing that ministry, then the prime minister, he has the authority to remove that kind of a persons from that particular ministry, and he allots that particular ministry to other members, other Lok Sabha members or Rajya Sabha members. So removal of the ministers is also one of the function of the prime ministers. And allocation of the portfolios, here this particular prime minister, he allocates the tasks to this particular ministers. Then next, power of prime minister is he is the head of the government. So as a head of the government, the prime minister is responsible for the all the actions of the government. Whatever the actions the government, that is the central government, will be taking, so the responsibility will be on the shoulders of the prime ministers. So as a prime minister, he coordinates the activities of the various ministers. Whatever the ministry list I said, okay, so there are many ministries we are having. So whatever the activities they will be doing in their particular ministries, okay, say the example, what is the activity this particular Ministry of Defense is doing. So that activity has to be coordinated by this particular post called a prime minister. So he coordinates with the each and every cabinet ministers, and he checks the progress of their ministry, and if there are any changes they have to do in that their particular work, he discuss with them, and they will sort it out the problems, and he gives sometimes he will be giving the suggestions to this particular ministers. So he coordinates the activities of the various ministers. So again, sometimes these particular cabinet ministers will be having some sort of problems in their ministries. Those kind of problems, they again they can come with the prime minister and they can discuss all those things, and possible solutions will be given by these particular prime ministers. Then, as a prime minister, he takes greater interest in framing the policies related to planning, defense, and foreign affairs. So, as a prime minister of the country, he shows a lot of interest in the planning related works, defense, and what is going on in the foreign affairs. And he holds, as I told you, as a head of the government, he holds in initial itself, I talked about there are many councils we are having where this particular prime minister works like the ex officio chairman. Whoever becomes the prime minister, they will be the head of these particular development councils, like, as I told you, Niti Aayog, National Development Council, National Integrational Council, Interstate Council, like this, whatever the councils and Aayogs we are having, the head will be the prime minister of this country. And they will be also head of this NWRC, which stands for National Water Resources Council. So this is of head of the government. So in this, as a head, he coordinates with his ministers and he shows interest in various policies related to the planning, defense, and foreign affairs. So that is the second thing. Then, as a prime minister, he enjoys the power, like he will be head of the union cabinet. As a prime minister, the meetings of the union cabinet are held under the chairmanship of the prime minister. So, as the prime minister of this nation, he will be conducting the meetings with the union cabinet members. So whatever the union cabinet members does the meetings, prime minister of the nation will be the chairman of that particular meetings, and all the discussions of the issues of the national and international importance are discussed in that particular meetings, and decisions are taken under his chairmanship. Whatever the decisions the council of ministers they want to take, so that should be taken under the guidance of the prime minister. They should inform whatever these ministers want to do or want to change in their particular ministries, they have to inform the prime minister, because he is the head of the government, right? Okay. Finally, the responsibility of the whole nation will be on the shoulders of prime minister. That we have to remember always. Then, as a prime minister, he provides the link between president and the cabinet. So whatever the cabinet ministries takes the decision, they inform to the prime minister, and prime minister will be taking that matter to the president. So as we know, president is the ultimate head of the nation. So whatever the changes, whatever the amendments they wanted to do, there should be a signature of the president on that. Until and unless president signs on that, they cannot make any changes. So as a prime minister, he will be heading the union cabinet. So this is somewhat what your particular lesson talks about. For your general knowledge, I have added this slide where I have added the information about present prime minister. Okay, so I am working this video for the academic year 2021. So present prime minister of this particular beautiful country is Sri Narendra Modi. So when you talk about Sri Narendra Modi, he will be serving this post. Since this is the second term, and he has selected with the absolute majority mandate from the citizens of India. Sri Narendra Modi has served as the Chief Minister of Gujarat for 13 consecutive years over 4 terms. So for 4 terms he has worked as a Chief Minister for the Gujarat. He transformed the state through what is now popular as the Modi model of governance. So whatever the changes, whatever the development he has done for the Gujarat, so that particular development is considered as the Modi model of governance, and other people are accept working on that particular model. So by seeing the work of Narendra Modi ji in the Gujarat, people have given him the absolute majority mandate. So he is now our beloved Prime Minister, serving second term again. He is the Lok Sabha member, that is the he is a member of parliament from the Varanasi, which is in Uttar Pradesh. Again, that is also second term. Sri Narendra Modi, he comes from the humble background, having started off as the tea seller at the Wadnagar railway station. As I told you at the initial talks of my this particular class, Narendra Modi, he has served as the tea seller in the railway station. So as a tea seller, by his dedication, by his workaholic nature, today he has become the Prime Minister. That is second term, second time he has become the Prime Minister of this particular beautiful country. So that is about thing. And Prime Minister Narendra Modi, he has taken the oath as the 15th Prime Minister of this particular nation. 15th Prime Minister he is. One activity, guys. So you have to tell me who is the first Prime Minister of this country. Let me know on this. Either in the chat box or else in the WhatsApp group. And okay, so that is about today's class, what I wanted to discuss about. Okay, so this particular Narendra Modi, and about his personal information, it is not for your particular syllabus. Okay, so just I have given the general information for you people. And which one thing I missed out, guys. Again, he is now he is 69 year old. Although he has the 69 year age, he works like a very young and dynamic leader, guys. We as the youngsters, we have to take a lot of inspiration from our Prime Minister of this nation. Okay. Somewhere I heard that as a Prime Minister, he works for 16 hours, okay, 15 to 16 hours, he will be working for our country's development. And somewhere I have heard as a Prime Minister, he very few leaves he takes for that particular PMO office. Okay, so we have to get motivated from this particular dynamic leader, and we have to somewhere we have to work for the